Hi guys, coming to you with another video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Okay, let's get started. Today we will be doing an extended ponytail. As you can see, I've already shampooed, conditioned, and blow dried her hair. So right now we're getting ready to silk out her hair and prepare it for the extended ponytail. She's natural, but she mostly wears it in its natural form, which are curls. And as you can see, her hair is very healthy, and it's very long. So, yep, I got it all silked out, and now we're getting ready to do the ponytail. So I'm just kind of combing it through, just letting you guys see just the health of her hair. And like I said, her hair is very healthy, which is a good thing because she shouldn't have any problems with wearing this ponytail. So go ahead and part that and get that out the way. So you're just watching me just part it and just getting it out the way. I'ma tell y'all, I have tried to do this video so many times on so many apps, and I don't know why it's giving me such a hard time. And I'm a little bit tired, so if I sound like I'm dragging, it's because I've been trying to edit this video, and I can't wait till I get it done. So hopefully this is going to be it. So right now I'm just making sure I put the ponytail where I want to, because like I said, I already got the bang parted off and to the side. So right now I'm just kind of like parting the hair and putting the ponytail where I want it to be. So you're just watching me kind of like trying to see why I want her hair to fall with the ponytail and everything. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And once I get that in place, I'll start molding the hair. Which is by Karakare. I absolutely love this wax stick. I have a lot of natural clients, and I use this wax stick to set and mold my clients' hair with it. It's a good combination to use with the Got to Be You holding spray. So this is what I do. I section the hair little by little, and I apply the Karakare wax stick. And as I apply it, I'm basically just molding the hair the way that I want to. So I do it little by little, section by section. And as I get the molding in place from the wax stick, I'll be using the Got to Be You hairspray to hold the hair in place. So right now you just see me on the other side. I've already done the left side, so now you just see me working on the right side. And like I say, you just see me just taking section by section, small parts, and just blending it in, getting a good mold. The wax stick gives the hair a nice sheen, a nice gloss, and just a good polished look when it comes to whatever you're trying to do as far as molding, because as you know, when you're natural, you can't use any type of white. I mean, I told y'all I was tired. You can't use any type of wet products to set the hair. So the wax stick and the Got to Be You holding spray, like I say, is a very good combination. And again, like I say, you're just watching me taking sections of hair. I do recommend that you take small sections. Take your time, because if you take your time and take small sections at a time, you'll get the best molding and it'll stay very well. It seems like a very long process, but it's very worth it. And it'll just make the work just look so clean and just so nice and neat. So you're just watching me just mold the hair in place. And then you'll soon see me use the spray, because I know you're probably like, I haven't seen Ty use the spray yet. But I'm going to use it right now. I'm just kind of focusing on just molding her up and just taking it in small sections, because she has a lot of hair. So I got it all up and I'm just still just going section by section, as you can see, little by little, taking my time, because I want this to be a very nice ponytail, because I believe this is her very first ponytail. I don't know, I'm not sure. Hopefully she can answer us in the comments if it is, because I don't know, but I think it is. So yeah. So I'm going to tell you guys, I am not the baby hair queen. I'm more of a classic type of girl, and I just feel like long as the edges are smoothed up really cute and nice and neat, that's fine with me, because I'm not a trend. I'm not with the trends, and I like baby hairs, don't get me wrong, but my issue with them is like, who wants to be trying to make sure that they stay or fix them when you're trying to wash your face in the morning? So I just make sure that I just give my clients just a nice, cute little swoop on the sides. Because like I say, who wants to be trying to fix their edges in the morning? So I have a more mature clientele, so I just make sure that everything is nice and neat and really cute and in place. So yeah, it is what it is. So now I'm adding another rubber band just for exercise. Wow, that rubber band broke. Well, your girl got another one. But I use extra rubber bands on the ponytails just for that reason right there, that the ponytail rubber bands might pop, like, but anyway, so I'll probably add like 3 or 4 rubber bands just for extra security, because like I said, you saw that rubber band pop, and we don't need no rubber bands popping out our ponytails and ponytails falling apart. No ma'am, we don't need that. So always just make sure that it's nice and secure, and add add more than just one rubber band just for extra security. And right here, you just seeing me just pretty much adding the got to be you spray to hold everything down nice and firm and tight. So right now, I'm just kind of finishing up with the got to be spray all around the ponytail. Up and all into place, I am braiding the end of the ponytail because that's what I'll be adding the extension for, the extension ponytail. So right now you're just watching me braid the hair. See me doing a sewing method. Now I used to glue my extended ponytails, but they are just so messy, and so the owner of the salon that I work at, she suggested that I sew the extension instead of gluing it, and that was the best thing that she could have told me. So right now you're just watching me wrap the hair around the braid. I do it several times. I think I do it more than several times, and I do it really tight. So I do it a good maybe 4 or 5 times really tight, and then I'll go in with my needle and thread and thread those tracks to the ponytail. So I keep doing that until I get all the way up to the ponytail right at the base of it. So right here, you just see me adding a couple of tracks to her bangs. She really didn't need them. I only added them because they have color, and I just wanted her to have a little bit of color in her bangs since she has color in her ponytail. So I pretty much eyeball how I add the extensions to her hair. She maybe have 2 or 3 extensions added to her bangs. I'm really not sure. I just pretty much eyeball everything to make sure it just looks natural to me, and I just go from there. Watching me curl her ponytail, adding curls for the girls. So yeah, so I'm pretty much done with the ponytail almost. I'm just adding the finishing touches, which is the curls, and I'll be adding some soft curls in her bangs as well.
So hold on.
watching me, just making sure everything is in place, making sure I get all the flyaways out the way, and just touching it up and stuff. But yep, we're done. She got closer to the camera. Yes, girl. All right. She loves it. Look at that beautiful smile through the mask. So, again, thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my channel. Thanks. And you guys have a good day.